I Have Lived a Thousand Years by Livia Bitten Jackson. Growing up in the Holocaust, Ellie Friedman, a 13-year-old girl living in Hungary, had a very normal childhood. She went to school and hung out with her friends just like any normal 13-year-old girl would do. One day, her brother came home from school in Budapest and said the Germans were taking over Budapest and arresting Jews. Once the Germans took over Ellie's hometown of Zamora, she was forced to wear the yellow star and paint the yellow star on her house. She became very ashamed of her religion. She didn't want to stand out, she just wanted to be like everyone else. Then all of the Jews of Zamora were sent to the ghettos to live. They were very small and many families had to live in one house. After living in the ghettos for a while, the women and children were piled into boxcars and rode in them for long periods of time, not knowing where they were going. They found out they were going to Auschwitz. The women at the camps were treated poorly and all of them had their hair shaved off. The moment their hair was shaved, they lost their sense of identity. From Auschwitz, they were taken to Plaszow. They were forced to work long, dreadful hours there. If you did one thing out of line, you risked harsh, painful punishment, and even sometimes death. After Plaszow, they were sent back to Auschwitz in boxcars so full they could barely breathe. When they arrive at Auschwitz, they get a number tattooed on their arms. They are no longer people, just numbers. One fateful day, Ellie's mom got very badly injured and became paralyzed. The day before a selection took place, Ellie had to sneak her mother out of the infirmary so they wouldn't be separated. They were next transported to Augsburg, which seemed like a heaven compared to Auschwitz. They were given real food and somewhat treated like real humans. They were given real clothes, but they were still forced to work in the factory. After their short paradise in Augsburg, they were sent to Dachau, where they were reunited with her brother. While on a train to a different camp, the boxcars were attacked by American fighter planes and many were killed. Will Ellie and her family make it out of the camps and safely to America?